Now friends, now I will be going on to explain the another type of controlling technique for induction motors, which is mostly used for industrial purpose. So that is nothing but variable voltage and variable frequency drive system. So what is that VFD? Variable frequency it stands for. It is used to control the speed of particularly for three phase induction motor, which uses power electronic devices to vary the voltage and frequency of the available supply voltage, that is 230 volt RMS with 50 hertz, and thereby to control the motor speed. So that VFD fundamentals, it is basically very simple. That VFD, it converts incoming 50 hertz utility power of AC, that is 230 mains, into DC, and then converts to a simulated variable voltage and variable frequency output. Now see, by this simple block diagram, you can easily analyze. As shown over here, AC input, it is shown as a 50 hertz. It is applied to the rectifier. Now we know what is the use of rectifier. It may be controlling or uncontrolled rectifier, that is either thyristor based or diode based respectively. Then that rectifier will be going to convert that input AC to DC, and the next block is shown as an inverter. Again, what is the use of inverter? That is to convert DC to AC. Now the question is, why it is converted? Because at the end you will observe the output available is AC in nature, and the original input was also AC in nature. Then why these intermediate two blocks are used? Why that conversion is done? That conversion is done for this purpose only, that is for variable voltage and variable frequency output. Means what? Suppose this 50 hertz to 30 volt AC, it is converted to DC by somewhat control rectifier. Already you learn various control rectifiers, three phase or single phase control rectifiers, right? So depending on the firing angle of thyristors which are used in that control rectifiers, the net output voltage or average output voltage, we can vary, is it? And that's why it is known as a variable voltage. So to have the output somewhat less than 230 volt RMS, we will go on to, or we can step down it over here only by providing somewhat non-zero firing angle. So the converted DC, it will have somewhat low value, and then it will be converted to AC, which will have its RMS value somewhat less than the input AC, that is 230 volt RMS. That's why it is titled as a variable voltage. Now another term, that is variable frequency. Now again, already in inverter section you already discuss and you already learn about this three phase inverter. Depending on the switching angle or switching frequency of these MOSFETs, that is thyristors, the frequency of obtained AC wave, that will get changed, or we can change it, is it? And that's why it is titled as a variable frequency. Now depending on the motor requirement or to control the speed of that motor, induction motor, we can either change the voltage or we can change the frequency of that AC which is applied to the motor, so that we can easily control the speed of that AC motor, right? So the same block diagram, it is replaced over here as like three phase AC line which is given to three phase converter. Here the converter, that is rectifier, it is shown as a uncontrolled, that is by using diodes, so that the obtained DC, it is stored over here, which is titled as a DC bus, and that DC bus voltage available, it is applied as a input to this three phase inverter, correct? So that was the simple mechanism of that VFD, or we can call it as VVVFD, that is variable voltage variable frequency drive. Okay, now as per the previous discussion, see, if that switch is close and open with these timings, means this, if this wiper is shifted over here and kept connected over here for this much time period, then the obtained output will have the logic high level for this much time. Similarly, if the switch is shifted towards the downward side, then the obtained output will be negative, we will have this much time period. So this total T, it will go on to decide the frequency of that obtained AC, output AC, is it? And in another way, if that switch is connected towards the upper side, that wiper is connected towards the upper side, and turn on and turn off it between these two points only, so that the obtained output will be pulsating in nature like this. So here we can say there will be somewhat less RMS value as the output is, or that switch is multiple times on and off, is it? Similarly, we can change its capital T also, that means we can change the frequency also, right now. So this is nothing but the simple mechanism of this VFD. Now, the output of a three-phase rectifier, we already derived for control rectifier the output, three-phase rectifier output, that is VDC equals to 3 under root of 3 Vm divided by 2 pi in bracket 1 plus cos alpha. Again, the firing angle of the thyristor, it will going on to decide the average value of obtained DC voltage by that three-phase rectifier, is it? Similarly, the maximum value of line-to-line supply voltage, that is VML equals to under root of 3 times of Vm, and hence that the maximum average output voltage that occurs at a delay angle alpha, if we said that alpha equals to 0 degree, then we can see it is uncontrolled rectifier, that is just like a diode base, and in that case the obtained average DC voltage, that will be 3 under root of 3 times Vm by pi, or simply you, whenever you want to keep alpha equals to 0 in this equation, you will get the same, that is 3 under root of 3 times of Vm by pi. So why these equations I highlighted over here? By changing the firing angle, we can change the value of this DC voltage, that is we can vary the voltage level, is it? Similarly, by using three phase inverter, again in previous unit we discussed about the line to line or phase voltage or phase to neutral, etc. So over there, phase to phase, that is VAB, we derived that equation as 2 under root of 3 EDC, this is nothing but the available input DC voltage by pi into sine of omega t plus pi by 6. And similarly for another phase to phase, that is VBC and VCA, so you will observe again that phase to phase available voltage, it will be dependent on the angular frequency, is it? So how the speed gets controlled using this VFD? So here few points are highlighted. Motor speed, that is RPM, which is dependent upon the frequency of that AC wave, or by varying frequency, by varying the frequency, output of that VFD gets controls. Then the motor speed, that is in RPM, which is equals to frequency in hertz into 120 divided by number of poles. These are the derived equations which you already learned. Okay. So for example, suppose there is a 4-pole motor which is operated at different frequencies, that is by the output of that inverter. If it is of 60 hertz, then that motor will get operated by 1800 RPM. That 4-pole 3-phase induction motor, it will get operated by 1800 RPM. If the inverter output, it is set to 50 hertz, then the speed of that motor, it will get changed to 1500 RPM like this. And similarly for 40 hertz, then it will go up 1200 RPM only. So the advantage of that variable voltage, variable frequency drive is what, as VFD makes the motor to start from the lower point, the motor starts smoothly, and as well as it, we can stop it smoothly. It also reduces the sudden jerks that tend to happen at the start of that three-phase induction motors, and as a result a large amount of energy gets saved. Now the applications. So it is mostly preferred in leather industries, then spray painting, water flow control, cranes, elevators, etc. At the end, what is the conclusion? It provides the most efficient means of motor speed control, reduces the thermal and mechanical stresses on the motor, provides low motor starting, and saves the energy.